All around the world, plants that are related to crops can be found in the wild. They are called crop wild relatives. Since the beginnings of agriculture, crop wild relatives have been used as a source of traits to improve the yields and nutritional quality of crops.
All of the crops we have today have crop wild relatives associated with them. So if we think of wheat, wheat comes from the Fertile Crescent, which is Jordan, Israel, Syria, Lebanon, Turkey, into Iraq. And the wild relatives, which originally gave rise to wheat, came from that region, and the wild relatives are still found in that region.
Farmers tolerate the presence of crop wild relatives on the farm because they recognize the value that these crop wild relatives bring to their cultivated plants in terms of genetic material that get transferred from these wild plants to their cultivated plants, and they benefit from traits like resistance to pests and diseases. They are much more adapted to the local condition from drought or salinity or other abiotic stresses.
It's estimated that the overall value of crop wild relatives is $120 billion per year. That's how much value they have to crop breeding.
Habitat loss, environmental degradation, deforestation and urbanization are causing the loss of crop wild relatives. Climate change is another major threat for these species, but at the same time, crop wild relatives are a crucial part of the solution for addressing the impact of climate change on agriculture.
By virtue of the fact that crop wild relatives have been evolving in nature, they have been able to develop new adapted traits that can be useful for farmers, for breeders, to produce varieties that can be more resistant or tolerant to the impacts of climate change.
So the crops we have today are unlikely to continue yielding in a different environment. So we're looking for traits that can withstand climate change, and they're not found within the traditional material used by plant breeders. So they're found in these crop wild relatives, which have made greater breadth of diversity than the crops themselves.
The best way to conserve crop wild relatives is to conserve them in the site where they originally occur, because they are in the natural environment, they are continuing to evolve with the nature. What we would do is to first look at what ways can we continue to maintain them in situ, either through conservation intervention or through assisted migration, where we allow these crop wild relatives to migrate to more favorable environments. If that's not possible, then the alternative option is to collect them and conserve them in gene bank in ex situ collections. It is our role as a human species to protect nature, to take care of it so that it can continue to provide the services that it brings to humanity. And crop wild relatives is a good example to show how we can connect nature to agriculture in providing important traits that will allow us to feed ourselves and our future generations.